Hi, dear aspirants and students of world. Welcome to my channel. Thank you for joining my educational channel. Today I am giving lecture on the important topic of political science for competitive examinations in the world and masters in political philosophy, economy, and international relations. The topic is political philosophy of Niccolo Machiavelli. He was born on 3rd May 1469 in Florence, a city of Italy, and died on 21st June 1527. He was an Italian thinker, political philosopher, best known for his eternal book, The Prince, which was written in 1513 and published after his death, after posthumous. Western philosophers have considered him as father of modern political philosophy, secularism, and above all, supremacy of state over all institutions. His posthumous work has contributed to the formation of modern national and world politics and source of republicanism that spread throughout Europe, North America, and entire world. Machiavelli has left indelible impact on succeeding philosophers, Catholic and Protestant king of the Europe of that time. His works were The Prince, second, The Art of War, which was written in 1520, History of Florence, Diplomatic Writing and Correspondence. Before understanding any question, any philosophy or political philosophy of any philosopher, student must be acquainted with social, political, and economic country of his country, region, neighborhood, and world at large. Machiavelli, the detested and adored prophet of secularism and authoritarianism, was born in Florence, Italy, at a time when the social, political, and economic conditions of his country was deteriorated because of social decadence, factional strife. People were fighting with each other on ideological basis, on sectarian basis, internal disturbances. Politically, the country was unstable. Interference and conspiracies of European countries into his country. Pope of their time waged sinister wars and hedged conspiracies against not only Italians but also European people, entire European people, and kept people subjugated in the chains of religion, which was practiced by them, not the original religion. Great Britain, France, Spain, Germany, and the Holy Roman Empire were meddling in the affairs of Italy. If we cast a glance on the pages of history, see the books of history, or know the history of the world, it reveals that every ruler or philosopher struggled for the attainment of lost glory, which they lost due to certain reasons, glory and aggrandizement of his country. So did the Machiavelli. Machiavelli also strived. His preferred prophet means explained, suggested method was better and different, but the goal was noble. Goal was noble, lofty, high ideal. Let us cast a glance on the social, political, and economic conditions of Italy at that time, not of today. Social conditions. Socially, Italians were degraded, meanness, coercion, debauchery, profligacy, means malevolence, bad conditions, had become the stepping stone of success in Italian society. Religion and religious institutions became playing tools in the hands of debased clergymen who corrupted and twisted religious principles in their interest. Social disruption had reached its highest peak. The people were groaning under innumerable hardships. Men, when separated from law and justice, become the worst of all animals proved in the Italy. Means there was a law of jungle. There was no any law. Law of jungle was prevailing at that time. Now come to the political and economic condition. The political and economic conditions were deteriorated, were worsened, were bad, were unstable because of unstable, impotent government, social decadence, internal disturbances, and external intrigues of neighboring countries, just like Germany, France, Spain, Greece. These were meddling with the internal affairs of Italy. There was no stable or powerful political authority or government to solve the socio-economic problems and consolidate the fragmented, disunited Italian peninsula. The people were leading a miserable life due to unending political jousts, economic deprivation, the deteriorated social, economic, political conditions stirred his mind, and left indelible impact on his political philosophy that shaped the contour of future political philosophy. Means laid the basis of future political philosophy. The political and economic developments, in other words, means other countries were progressing. They were developing, achieving success. And economic development in other countries of Europe also influenced his philosophy. He was seeing that France is progressing, that England is progressing, but we are not progressing. We are on the lowest head. What was this basis of political philosophy? The other nations of Europe were developing economically and gaining strength. Macaulay firmly believed in economic determinism or potency and observed a close connection between political and economic stability, political power and economic stability. Macaulay, as a true Florence or an Italian, was naturally shocked to see the political upheavals, social disgruntlements, economic plight of his country determined are firmly saved, carried out his determined to save and unite his motherland. He served in various capacities and keenly observed, keenly researched the root causes and proffered or suggested solutions in the shape of what he think necessary or suitable in the shape of a prince, the prince, what was written in his book, The Prince. His main philosophy was the interest of Italy, not the interest of France, not interest of the German or Spain, but interest of the Italy first and supreme. He was the first philosopher. If we go to the political, read the political philosophy, we see that he was the first political philosopher who propounded the priority of country over all other institutions. The current national and international politics is the continuation of this philosophy. If we say, look at the present work, we see that every president, every government, every people strive for, not for the progress of other country, but progress, stability, political stability, economic prosperity of his, and they say, my country is the first. All states of world, weak or strong, strive to preserve their vital national and global interest and do not compromise over it. Therefore, in Machiavelli's philosophy, we see the selfishness, audacity, cunning, deception, treachery, malevolence, hatred in the mentality of prince or ruler to achieve what? To achieve nobler object of Italian integration and political and economic stability. Now, if you see each and every president or government of the country strive and do not compromise on the interest of his country, but they will fight, they will maneuver to achieve their interest. Now, the term Machiavellism has become a synonym or similar for expediency over truth and virtue. Sorry. He denounced all the church doctrines and held the popes responsible for the plight of state of affairs of their time. He pleaded for using even oppressive means for attaining the social coherence, economic prosperity, political stability, glory, and magnificence of Rome. Rome is the capital of Italy, by consolidating all scattered forces. He regarded fear as dominating weapon in the hands of a prince to get complete obedience from the people who would follow him. His political philosophy reformed. If we see that after 16th century, many countries were reformed. His philosophy was the basis of that reforms. His philosophy reformed and integrated Italy into a powerful country that she was able then to fight with the European powers. If we see in the First World War, Italy fought with the European countries and become a colonized, colonial power. The religious reformer of South Asia, South Asian continent, just like Mujaddad Arab Sani, Shah Wali Ullah, also followed his philosophy. Our other reformers of the world followed his philosophy. They ultimately forced the imperial power to withdraw from the world. From United States, they threw colonial powers. From South Asia, from Africa, all colonial powers were thrown away, were fought. And what was that? That was the basis of nationalism. Our country must be our, not of others. Supremacy of state over morality, religion, and other institutions. If we see in America, state is supreme. If we see the Constitution of Britain, Britain is supreme. In Britain Constitution, even here, it is, she has unwritten Constitution, but that is supreme over other. No, the Parliament of Britain can make a man a woman. It is more powerful than other institutions of the Great Britain. During the Renaissance, during the Renaissance, Florence was the cradle of Italian knowledge and learning. His political philosophy was based on scientific and empirical study, which played a pivotal role in the rooting out, eliminating rivalries of France, Spain, and Germany. For Machiavelli, virtue consists in power, which results from a mixture of force and intellect. He gave priority and elevated the position of state above all institutions, whether religious or political. If we see an American Constitution, American political system, the state of America is supreme. If we see the Constitution of Britain or France, their state is supreme. Governments come and go. Governments are changed within years, but state remains supreme. The interest of the state is supreme. It is fixed. No any government can compromise on it. And who propounded this? Machiavelli propounded this. He believed that state was the essential and highest form of association through which men or citizens could materialize his ends and live a perfect and virtuous life. Without state, there is no life. There is a law of jungle. When the in his political philosophy, he said, when the existence of state confronts grave threat, there must not be any consideration for what is just or unjust, cruel or merciful. But state has to act. State is indispensable instrument for human welfare. He considered state welfare superior than the well-being of individuals at that time. Now it has turned reverse. Now the well-being of individuals are superior than the state, because state is consist of individuals. His only motive why he said such things, because his only motive was, as an Italian, as a true patriot, was the exaltation of his state. For that, he despised all institutions which harmed, which eroded Italy. As such, he laid the foundation of modern nationalism. Now we see all people of the world work, supposed to be work, are working for the glorification, for the good name of his country, not the other country of other. The history reveals the fact that the glorification of state people went to war for glorification or for attainment of national interest. People went to war and inflicted heavy cruelties on humanity, irrespective of color, race, origin, and religion. Anybody can fight with anybody, no matter he is a Christian, he is a Muslim, he is a Hindu, but when their interest is in danger, they will fight. The European colonial powers followed this eternal principle and ultimately conquered the entire world by killing millions of people. Why? To glorify, to aggrandize, to make them powerful, their countries. Even it is wrong, but they did so. The European colonial powers conquered Africa, North and South America, and Asia. The USA also followed this policy of principles and policy and dropped the atomic bomb, nuclear bomb, to secure country from foes and friends in future. Why United States dropped atomic bomb on the Japan? To only to secure that no country dare to drop or fight with America, because America say, I am a powerful, I have power, I have muscles. Muslim countries could not strive. Now I am giving an example of Muslim countries. Muslim countries could not strive to so much to glorify their state, remain subjugated despite political independence. They are politically independent, but they are subjugated in one or other way. And abundant economic resources. They have nature, lot of natural resources. All the Western countries are dependent on their natural resources, but even they are politically subjugated. They are looking for any for military hardware, for any technology to the countries who are glorified. Machiavelli and religion. What was the Machiavelli's perception about religion? Machiavelli does not believe in any ethical or religious dogmas and divine law practiced by the clergy of that time. In his view, religious authorities were misusing the religion and held them responsible for the deterioration of Italy. He concluded that the institution of papacy brought decline and destruction to the glory of Rome. Religion failed to solve social, political, economic problem of the people and state. Machiavelli saw religion as, now it is clear that he was not an unbeliever of Christianity, but on the conditions forced him to think about or say these things. Machiavelli, in his view, religion only is a cementing force which bind society together, because societies are formed on the basis of, at that time, ideology. Religion in the hands of Pope makes men weak and inactive. They were looking for solving of their problem to the popes, not to the state. The individuals were only bound to follow the laws of ethics and morality in social relationship with each other. In social intercourse, they have to follow the prescriptions, the respect standards of religion, which is clear, and it is in society. State must adopt principles of expediency for its safety, for its supremacy and integrity, even assert social and political rights. If a country goes to the war, no any individual will go to the court and ask the Supreme Court to stop the war. No, because it is war is in the interest of that country. Therefore, he intentionally segregated politics from religion and pleaded that state should not be governed on the principles of religion and morality. Now we see that there are a lot of countries which are not governed on the basis of religion. No doubt, all political philosophy, all constitutions of the world are based on the religion. But there are certain limitations, there are prescriptions they are following, because religion is also for the well-being of a people. But how it is practiced, whether the practitioners are misusing it or not. He advocated the idea of secularism and regarded father of, that's why he was regarded as the father of secularism. According to his philosophy, politics should be non-religious. The moral and religious precepts should be subordinate to the interest of state. The church and the religious authorities should exist within the state, not above the state, and not defy the state institutions. If we see the present world of 2020 or this century, the modern states like Great Britain, France, USA, China, Russia, and even India have adopted this principle of secularism, and as a result, achieved economic prosperity and political stability. They are powerful, economically powerful countries of the world, vying with each other. It is believed that Machiavelli was not irreligious, but not religious, not immoral, but unmoral. He emancipated politics from theology and moral philosophy. This principle of state supremacy is rampant in the third world Muslim world of country and Muslim countries until today. Their rulers use this principle of expediency in time of crisis. When the time of crisis or danger comes, there is no any other thinking about the state. All must bow to the state supremacy. The forms of government. In his philosophy, in Machiavelli's philosophy, regarding form of government was a mixed type of constitution. With proper check and balances, he considered it most suitable for economic equality and political stability of state. The best constitution is one that apportions legal rights among princes of nobles and people in proportion to their real power. For under such constitution, revolution is not possible. They will not revolt against the government, against the state, which gives them rights, gives them their proper position. He realized that different forms of governments suited different times and places. To him, an elected powerful monarchy, because at that time there was no elected monarchy, and monarchy was prevalent in the European countries. But in his idea, elected monarchy means supported by the people, elected by the people, mandated by the people, would be the best to Italy. That leads to more uniform and universal material prosperity and ensure greater equality of opportunity. Elected monarchy is stable, according to his political philosophy. Elected monarchy, which has support of the people, like in democracy, is stable and enduring, admitting liberty more than unpopular monarchies or dictatorship. Elected monarchy, his chief objective, his chief goal was efficiency and integrity of state. For this end, for this purpose, he wanted an extra legal, omnipotent or all powerful sovereign to regain past glory and emancipate, liberate Italy from the foreign power, that are German, French, Spanish, who had snatched the political and economic power. Hence, Machiavelli wanted to revive the ancient glory and greatness of the Italian state by establishing a despotic and absolute republic form of government in the shape of a prince who can fight with or snatch their things from others, who become a powerful because when he has a political support of the people, he can fight. Now come to the modern world. The major powers of the world adopted a republican form of government, means democratic form of government, adopted, achieved political stability and economic prosperity. If America was ruled by a monarchy, what was the shape of today's America? It would have been different. But they have adopted a republican form of government, a democratic form of government. That's why they achieved prosperity and worked for the welfare of American people. The example of USA, Great Britain, France and other countries vindicated this doctrine of Machiavelli. After the end of World War II, newly emerged states of world were not allowed by powerful countries to reap the fruits of republicanism, a democratic form of government. The powerful countries deliberately kept them in a state of civil war on ideological grounds to save them from the threat of communism, the perceived threat of communism. In the course of time after the end of Cold War between superpowers, these countries, subjugated countries, freed themselves and adopted republican form of government and marching to political stability and economic prosperity. Now we see where all countries are, 99% countries of the world have adopted a democratic form of government. Either it is presidential form of government or parliamentary form of, but they have democratic. Only few countries are with monarchy or dictatorship. Even now they have, these dictators or monarchies have given more powers to save their government, more powers to the people. They have conceded their powers, or other countries of the world forced them to concede, to give the rights to the people. Now we come to the book, the parents. What are they? Parents is actually a roadmap presented to the Medici, the parents of Florence of that time. It gives our parents, gives an inspiring technique for successful government, governance, state diplomacy, and guide, and a roadmap and guide suggestions, not only of his time, but also the succeeding times for making state politically stable, socially coherent, united, and economically powerful, stable. According to his philosophy, parents must possess the qualities of wisdom, egoism, selfishness, and sagacity. Do you think that any country can flourish with an unwise fool king or ruler? No, because it is the quality of a ruler to rule in the interest of country in a suitable way. He prescribed that parents exercise all despotic means for state stability. Now, let me explain why America is killing Iranian generals, Iranian scientists. Why? Are Iranians are killing Americans? Are Chinese are fighting with America? America is fighting economically with China. Only what? Only to save their country, or to achieve their vital established interest. He advised or suggested parents that for curbing internal chaos which was prevalent at that time in the Italy and countering ulterior designs of foreign powers, a strong military is sine qua non, means essential. A prince to control the conditions of a state within and fight with the outside worlds who are meddling into his affairs, the prince must raise a powerful military. And now we see that the modern armed race is the continuation of his principles of safety of individual and state. The powerful countries, how they become powerful? Because they establish powerful militaries. Any country who does not have powerful military are subjugated or to some extent lowest in the earth. One cannot dare to talk with other powerful countries like Nepal, like Bhutan. They have no military. The nations and countries that ignored achieving power to deter others collapse are subjugated by powerful states. Muslim rulers neglected the strong military on modern pattern, lost their empires to powerful colonial powers equipped with modern military. If we go to the history of Mughals, he died on 1526, and on that time Babur was a head of military, but his succeeding princes or succeeding monarchs could not maintain powerful military. That's why they lost to the colonial powers of Britain, and their state was fragmented into many parts because due to the lack of a powerful military. The people of Europe are brutal and selfish. After securing economic prosperity by plundering, looting the resources of world, they are not fighting with each other. Now, at present, if you see the world or the issues of the world, there is no any conflict between any European state, but conflict or issues are with third world countries because they are brutal, selfish, and they are only because they have sacrificed lot of things in First World War and Second World. Now they have realized that war is not a solution. That's why they have collaborated with each other to gain interest at the cost of others. The doctrine who rules the waves, rules the world, proved because the European countries ruled the waves, means established a powerful navy, which led to their success. And the countries that do not raise a powerful navy lost their empires, lost their countries without any resistance. If we do now see the modern technological warfare, these countries are more advanced. They have power to do anything, anywhere in the world, because they have achieved technology. Position of man in his philosophy. What was the position of man or individual in his philosophy? Machiavelli said that ambition and interest is inherent part of human nature. Every human seek his own interest, not the interest of his brother, no, his own interest. And therefore, clash or conflict is inevitable. Both brothers will fight, will snatch with skirmishes, will fight with each other to gain their interest. Machiavelli considered man brute and combination of evil instinct. At the time, it was a law of jungle, and man was brute, and combination of evil or instincts or senses. Man behaves in good manner or properly only for material gain. If I have something to gain, and will I be, oh, how are you fine, sir? I'm glad to see you. But if I'm not getting these things, I will fight. No, I will snatch it. This is the mental approach of every people, not of Italian, but of every people. So, according to Machiavelli philosophy, man behaves in good manner only for material gain, are in fear of reaction. If I see that, if I take this thing from this man, he will fight with me, he will do reaction, and I will become a noble, and I will not fight with him. If he is weaker, then I will fight. It is the real politics of today's world. Without economic prosperity, man becomes brute because empty stomach has no morality. Now, without his philosophy or his prescription, without economic prosperity, man becomes brute, ready to harm interest of his fellow man. He advocated giving more powers, economic, social, political powers to people after attaining what? After attaining last glory of Italy. Not now. After, when we gain the last glory of Italy, then the prince will give powers to the people. Not then, he was not allowed to snatch these powers. But he will give. But first he has to attain the last glory and unite his Italy. People are saying yes, because when they get their last glory, economic prosperity, social coherence, political stability, they become sagacious to show judgment in selection of officers, our president, our prime minister of par excellence, for state administration, who must work freely and independently. Then a prince who is, because that prince was not elected, he was imposed from time, from coming son. See? Then now the elected prince, or see, the elected president, elected prime minister, will act in the interest of state, not interest in the interest of any mafias or groups, because at that time all the parents who have had no political stability or political strength or political support of people were vulnerable by the court interviews and influences of foreigners. Thank you very much.